About the address, miss?
Yes, this is the place. You'll be sure and wait for me now, won't you?
Sure, I'll wait. Come on.
Funny. Number, please.
Oh, I'm at 122 Old Mill Road. This house hasn't been occupied for 13 years, and yet there's a telephone in it. Can you tell me who had it installed?
I wouldn't have that information, madam. I could connect you with a night supervisor, but she'd have to wait until the business office opens in the morning. I'm sorry.
All the modern improvements. You might have cleaned the place up a bit. Oh, yes, of course. Dad sat there.
Marjorie, Uncle Dick, Aunt Joan, Uncle Wayne, and
Mr. Barksdale? Mr. Barksdale, is that you? Mr. Barksdale? Mr. Barksdale?
Police station, Captain Ryan speaking. Yeah? The old Morgan place?
He says he drove a youngster out there about 30 minutes ago.
Hold the driver, I'll be right over.
Okay.
Wake up, you dumb mass of muscle, and get going. Miss Stuyvesant, 9600. You can go. Leave your address. We'll want you later.
Yes, sir.
What? Well, keep ringing them.
Hello.
Hello, Phil. This is Ryan. Listen. We've got a swell case down here.
I'm not interested.
Give me Stuyvesant 9600.
When you hear the tone of the gong, it will be exactly 12 o'clock and 6 split seconds.
Ring that number again. Hello, hello, you. Say, what's the idea of putting that dame on the phone? I know what time it is.
What time is it?
Shut up. No, I don't mean you. Don't hang up. I want you to get over here right away. There's been a murder. I know, but this is a good murder. Listen, 13 years ago, a guy invited all his... Suppose not. I've got a hunch I'll be thinking about it for some time myself. Let us hear about that phone call from Barksdale, and I'll let you go.
Well, there isn't much to it, except that Barksdale called her a few days ago and gave her some instructions. Something she was supposed to do on her 21st birthday.
And you don't remember what they were?
I know. She wouldn't tell me.
And we're supposed to find the answer. Does anybody know anything? What's the matter with the old man besides being nuts? Are you sure this dinner wasn't held in an insane asylum?
What?
Try and calm down. Take these boys to the next office and give them some paper and pencils. And send Carter in.
Yes, sir.
You boys better stick around. We might want you. It's too bad, son. Take care of yourself.
And what do you mean?
Nothing much.
You mean they might go after me?
They might.
Well, I don't think I'd care if they did.
Well, we would. It cost the department a lot of dough to investigate a murder.
Well, in that case, I'll be careful. Well, thanks. You've been very considerate today.
That's all right, son. Well, what do you think?
I can't think. I'm numb. Why the devil does a man have to go through all that hocus-pocus just to leave a will? It burns me up.
Well, stop burning. Carter will make you happy.
Yeah?
Hey, Carter. Let's see what you got.
Yes, sir. Here are the deposits.
He has a laugh for you.
Really? Well, let's have it.
You're next.
What?
According to Mr. Winston's theory, you're next on the list. Unless, of course, you've been doing the murders yourself.
Really, Marie, you've always had the most peculiar sense of humor.
Must be some more of the family. I'm doing the resurrection act.
And enjoying it thoroughly, if I know you. You certainly startled me.
Did I?
Mr. and Mrs. Thornton, Mr. Winston and Miss Thornton.
How do you do?
How do you do?
If you'll explain your reasons.
Well, for heaven's sake, I thought you were dead.
Disappointed?
Well, why be a hypocrite? You know I've always hated your...
Marjorie, if you say that word again, I'll disown you.
What a loss. Is this for private use only? I suppose you're a Winston.
Don't touch her, Marjorie.
Hey, what's the matter? What? She says that you remind her of her mother. Oh!
Pipe down! You can't do this.
I demand
that. Yes, I know. You're going to write a letter to the commissioner.
I won't stay in here another moment.
Say, what are you trying to do, rip me?
Dear me, no.
Say, if you guys don't dummy up, there's gonna be a murder.
Well, that's what we're here for. Two murders. He did them.
What? Hey, pipe down
here. Here, officer. I demand it.
Oh, go read your ticker. I want to know what Steele's doing. All there, Sergeant.
Okay.
All there, Mr. Winston.
Okay, thanks. Oh, wait a minute. Turn them all loose, but put a man on each one of them. Now, I'll be responsible.
How'd you like our city jail? Listen, child. I want you to destroy that slip of paper at once. And don't tell anyone what was written on it. Not even your brother. But no one's accusing your brother. Say, listen, don't you get too smart. You know, there's a distinct prejudice in the police department against little girls who go around stealing police cars. Oh, you're not. Well, 21's a mere drop in the bucket. Say, will you shut up and let me talk? Now listen, don't tell anyone those numbers. And if anyone tries to get them out of you, let me know immediately. Will you do that? Like a sweet little girl?
That was the great sleuth, Winston.
Yeah. What did he want?
He told me not to tell anybody the numbers on that slip of paper.
What numbers?
1313.
Shame on you, looking at those things.
Huh?
Why don't you have luncheon with me? It'll be more comfortable than standing out here.
How'd you know I was following you?
Have you ever been to the zoo?
Sure.
Did you see the elephants?
Yeah.
Well, that's how I know.
Huh?
I'm afraid you're not very bright. But you may come in handy. I'm about to go calling. Would you like to come along?
I gotta go wherever you go.
Is that a theme song, or just your quaint way of saying things?
Oh, well, I...
You'd better ride with me. You know, I'm getting a pain in the neck from looking back at you. Come on. Of course, just looking at you may give me a pain in the neck. Get in.
Okay, stay there until you relieve. That was Bentley, detailed to watch Adams. He says Adams hasn't left the house all day, but some dame just came up in a limousine with Grump.
Grump? He's tailing the Thornton girl.
Tailing her?
He's riding in the limousine with her.
What?
I'd give $100 to see that.
Come in.
Was it? Oh, honey. Oh, get a picture of Jensen and show it to the doctor, will you, please? Hello, operator. Get me Douglas in 968. Hurry it.
That's the one.
Hurry with that call.
Hello? Oh, yes.
Now listen, child. Don't get in a panic, but get out of the house as quick as you can. Is there an officer guarding it?
Yes. He let me in.
I swear I didn't.
We know all about Sherwood and the other girls, so you may as well tell us the rest. Who was in on this with you?
Barksdale.
So you killed her and then Barksdale so you wouldn't have to split, huh?
No, I don't know who killed them. I swear it.
Pick up that phone.
No, no.
Why not?
Because that's the way Leela got it.
You were there that night. Did you kill her?
No, I saw her after
it. After shooting at Miss Morgan?
no, I didn't.
Now you're a liar. Go on, take him down and lock him up.
Come on.
But, Phil...
I tell you, Ryan, it doesn't make good sense. Why go to all the trouble to impersonate someone and then kill the impersonator? Jensen tried to kill Miss Morgan, but somebody else killed the girl thinking it was Miss Morgan. Jensen knew the difference. There have been two different factions working in this against each other.
Why, that... But where's...
Exactly. Get an axe. Break that wall in.
All right.
And son, you'd better go on back to the station.
Why?
Because I don't think your sister's going to be alive when we find her.
I don't know.
Tell me.
No.
You know what they are. Tell me. Tell me.
I know, but if you kill me, you'll never know.
You little fool. Don't you know that I'll kill you anyway? Tell me.
Got a patent on that little electrical device of yours, Adams?
No, I'm sorry to say. I haven't.
Well, I wouldn't worry about it if I were you. The state's got something that works along the same lines. And we're going to give you an exclusive demonstration. Take him out.
Come on, move.
Will they let you into that safety deposit box?
Sure.
What did you find?
Only $1 million in securities for her.
A million?
How disgusting. I hope it isn't U.S. Steel.
Don't worry, it isn't. I left the securities there, of course, but this letter was on top and I thought you'd want it.
Thank you. To Marie, the 13th guest. Can you imagine that? I was it all the time. The poor lamb. Read it.
Aloud?
Why, yes.
My dear child, I am making a rather melodramatic attempt to protect your fortune. But if I am right about the other members of the family, it is almost certain to reveal them to you in their true light, so that you will not make the same mistake I made when I married into it. Bless you, my dear, and maybe have killed each other off by the time you receive this, your father. It's sad, but it's also darn good advice.
What?
Not to marry into a screwy family.
Hello.
Hello, Phil. This is Ryan. Listen, I've got another swell...
I'm not interested.
When you hear the tone of the gong, it will be exactly 12 o'clock and 6 split seconds.
Uh-oh. Hello? Ring Stuyvesant 9600 and keep ringing it. And when you've done that, well, ring it some more.